So we're going to discuss the technical architecture of a typical SAP system. Then we're going to move on to the landscape architecture and just discuss why we break our landscape into multiple systems. Here we have a slide showing a three-tier client-server architecture of a typical SAP system. At the top, we have the presentation server. The presentation server is any input device that we can use to control an SAP system. So here we're showing the SAP GUI. But we're not limited just to using a SAP GUI. We can use a web browser, mobile device, or any other form of input you can think of. The presentation layer communicates with the application server. And the application server is the brains of an SAP system. This is where all the central processing gets done. You can see here, we're showing the application server isn't just one system in itself. Your application server can be made up of multiple instances of the processing system. Now, the application server in turn communicates with the database layer of the three-tier architecture. The database is kept on a separate server, a separate system in itself, mainly for performance reasons, but also for security as well. It provides a separation, and that's why we got these three different layers in this whole SAP system. The presentation server communicates with the application server. The application server does all the processing. It makes calls to the database. Data is passed back to the application server. More processing is done before the results are then sent to the presentation server. Now let's quickly discuss a typical landscape architecture. Now, I say typical, but you'll find that when you work with SAP, there is no typical, in inverted commas, landscape architecture that most companies use. What you do find that's very common is you'll find a development system, you'll find a testing system, and then you'll find a production system. Now, why do we have these three systems? Well, it's fairly straightforward. All the development work and initial unit testing that we do in our SAP work gets done on a development system. This ensures we do not affect any other system that is being used by the company. Once our developments we think are good enough to be tested by maybe an external source or someone else within your company whose role it is to carry out testing, we move our developments using what's called a transport system to the next system, which in this case is the testing system. On the testing system, normally no development is done at all. It's just used for testing what developments were carried out in the development system. If everything works out and everything passes in the test system, we then use a transport system again to move our developments or our program changes into the production environment. When code goes into a production environment, that's when it's turned on and that's when it's used within the business itself. Now, our landscape architecture is not separated just for development purposes. Your company can have other reasons. There can be the quantity of data that a normal production system holds. It can be too great to actually be used in the development environment, because normally your development system and your testing system are not as large as a production system. You only want a subset of data to test on. There's also the security element that you need to look at. More often than not, companies do not want developers to see live production data for data security issues. You know, you've got employee data on the system, you've got sales data, and you don't want people who are not involved in those specific areas to actually see the live data. So normally your development and testing systems have a different set of data that they can develop and test on. Now, I would say the three systems we have here are normally a minimum. You know, you've normally got your development system, testing system, then a production system. but it can increase to 4 systems. Maybe you want a training system. Maybe you've got multiple projects running at the same time. So maybe you've got 2 different development systems. You could then have 2 different test systems, you know, and then maybe a consolidation system before it's passed to the production environment. This is all dependent on the company that you're going to be working at. But one thing that is common is that each system that you do have in your landscape architecture will have its own application server and its own database server. This then ensures we have platform independence.